He missed it once any. Honored colleagues and guests, thank you for inviting me to be part of this celebration. What a privilege it is to be here for the installation of the Reverend Dr. S.P. Yongsan Kim Mok-sani. You may ask, what is a white clergy man doing on this program, especially one who does not speak Korean? Korean-American clergy women can speak for themselves. I pray that God give me a word of blessing, so you don't regret inviting me. I first met Esther Kim in 2000, when she became my co-worker in ministry. She helped our church to become, in fact, as well as in faith, a truly multicultural and multiracial church. She taught me about ministry with immigrants and cultures. She helped to broaden and deepen the spiritual community of a congregation suffering from the myopia of white privilege, and in the process made us a bit more evangelical. I hope I helped in her formation as well. Esther, you know that in a year as leader for the Korean American Clergy Women Association, you will not remake the organization, nor will you save the world through it. But you can help to sustain and advance all the good things about it. Keep it a place of hospitality, and even sanctuary, where Korean American clergy women can give and receive love and support for each other, where the isolation and loneliness that are often part of ministry can be eased a little bit. The work of ministry takes all of our energy. If we are to teach people to love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, we must do the same for all of our neighbors and, equally important, for ourselves. Clergy women, and women generally, are often expected to find strength beyond 100% to manage family life on top of ministry. If you are married to a clergyman, even one as understanding and compassionate as Kim Jang-gil Mok-sanim, you play the demanding roles of both Mok-sanim and Sanim. In the present climate, the work of your association is both much more difficult and more important than ever. With zero tolerance justifying intolerance towards outsiders, the recent scandal of children being stripped from their mother's arms, what you do is extremely important and also extremely difficult. At the same time, there seems to be growing a fear in South Korea towards immigrants and refugees. Some are afraid that Jeju Island could become an unrestrained Ellis Island. As clergy women, you are especially called to remind the parts of the church in which you minister that Jesus taught special hospitality to strangers and told his apostles to shake the dust from their feet from inhospitable towns. Esther, as you did for me on many occasions, you and your colleagues can teach the body of Christ about the racism, xenophobia, and misogyny that infect the church even to this day. If I am right, you can help to redefine Dangil Minjok. Because in God's eyes, all human beings are truly one single people. Acts 17:26. In this, I don't pretend to give marching orders, but only to make a promise that I will pray for you as you do this work. Perhaps together, if we each do our part, invoking a wise and gentle Presbyterian minister, Mr. Rogers, we can do a little bit to make this world a better neighborhood. God bless you. Pasadena.